Finally, it's January the 6th. Welcome to the big year! And this is our first trip out. Although we've seen quite a few garden birds at home over the last few days, including a very glamorous starling who was sunbathing on the roof this morning. This is our first time we can actually go out properly as it's been such terrible weather and I've had some work. So I've packed all of the cameras. I've got multiple cameras for birding, one which is huge and takes really great photos but isn't very good at video, and then a small one that takes great video but isn't very good at photos. So I tend to decide between one or the other, but this time I thought I would take both. Because hey, it's day one of the big year. We're heading to Aberystwyth first of all, where there's some beaches and rocky areas, and there's a pier, and that can attract all kinds of birds. There have been sightings recently of purple sandpipers and kingfishers and waxwings up the road, so who knows if we'll see any of those. Then we're going to go to Aberaeron, and we might have time to walk through the woods near Aberaeron to see some different sorts of birds there. So who knows, we should see a wide variety. So we get a lot of seagulls in like kind of urban coastal areas, and there are two like more common types of gull. Ironically, there is a species called the common gull, which isn't anywhere near as common as the other two. So the two that are common are the herring gull, which is sort of big, sort of slightly aggressive and cold looking, which, yeah, you find them in loads of towns, inland as well as on the coast. They've got that kind of yellow bill with a red blob in it, and they just look quite mean and arrogant and eat your chips if you're not careful. Then there's the black-headed gulls, which you do find around farmland as well, but they're often around coastlines and on estuaries, and they're a lot smaller. And confusingly, they don't have a black head for much of the year. They only really have a black head during the breeding period, so a lot of the time they've just got like a black splotch on their head. So yeah, two very different types of gull. There are more, as I'm sure I will see throughout the year. So we came to Aberaeron and then we just drove off into the wilderness a little bit, and we're now by the River Iron, which is incredibly full, as you can see behind me. I've never seen it like this. This woodland walk goes through to a house called Llanelli, which is a National Trust place. And it's a lovely walk through some woods, so we might get some woodland species. Just hit a little bit of the wood where it seems to be a bit of a thrush haven. So we've got like blackbirds, which are part of the thrush family, and robins, which are also sort of part of the thrush family, and then song thrushes, which you quite often find in woodland, and missel thrushes as well. I've seen a lot more missel thrushes around West Wales in the last few years for some reason, whether it's just where I live now or where I'm looking, but there's definitely seems to be more of them They're quite a bit bigger than song thrushes and a lot more sort of streamlined. But yeah, nice to see them out and about. So we made it nearly to Llanelli and it's just starting to get dark, so we're going to head back in a minute. We saw quite a few woodland birds, a few little ones that flit around in the trees and make it difficult to capture, like goldcrest and some long-tailed tits. Yeah, but got off to a good start. One thing I didn't mention in Aberystwyth, which is really the treat of the day, down in the rocks behind the pier was an amazing kingfisher that we kind of had an idea was around because we've seen it on Facebook a bit over the last few days. But it was just, yeah, showing off, doing a bit of fishing in the rock pools. Kingfishers are more often seen on riverbanks in freshwater, but they do also live near seawater. So that's the first time I've seen one actually on the coast. So a first for me and a good tick for the list. Anyway, we've got into the 20s, which is a very small start, but we're on the way. So it's Thursday, the 11th of January, and I had a frustrating few days. I had a bug, and I've been seeing lots of people posting pictures of waxwings that had visited Teifi Marshes Reserve over near Cardigan. And it's kind of one of our regular-ish spots, and I really wanted to go and see them. So today I've just about recovered enough to be able to stand up and walk around. And being as it's a big year, I really wanted to catch them. The good news is that I just saw a couple of waxwings. The bad news is that the age-old birdwatcher's dilemma, I chose binoculars over camera for the first glimpse, and then they flew away, so I missed them. We've been hanging around for a little while in case they came back, which apparently they do, but I'm flagging a bit. But still, we saw quite a few other birds, a very, very tame robin, and a few of the usual regular things that you might see at Kilgarran. But yeah, I'm going to go back and lie down for a while. Teifi Marshes, take two. It's now Monday the 15th of Jan and it's very cold but lovely. And we came over to Teifi Marshes again to see if we could see the waxwings, which looked as though they were still in town, so to speak. Seem to be waxwings all over the UK at the moment, which is interesting. And yes, they are still here, and yes, we finally got to get some footage and photos, so I'm very, very excited. They're beautiful birds. They only come when it's really cold winter down from Scandinavia or the north, and we don't very often get them in the west, so getting them in West Wales is pretty exciting. But I think there's been reports of them in Cornwall this year, so they seem to have spread over the whole UK. Beautiful birds with a tail that's been dipped in yellow wax, and yeah, just such a sleek, smooth finish on them. Really beautiful. We've seen lots of other birds as well, some waders and some ducks. Yeah, so it's been a productive afternoon. Thank you. Wednesday the 17th of January, and we're back at Aberystwyth again. We came up last week for the sort of first official big year trip out, but we didn't see the purple sandpipers that were nestling along the coast wall. There's been a lot of pictures of them on Facebook this week, so we're going to go and see if we can find them. Maybe we'll see another kingfisher sighting. Who knows what else? Down by the castle on Aberystwyth seafront, and yeah, there's some interesting birds around, some house sparrows nesting in the castle, as you do, and a rock pipit, which I haven't seen one of those yet this year, and they're not that common, so good one for the list. And yay for purple sandpipers, there was about seven of them all kind of hiding along the coast wall just above the sea level, looking very cold, in the shade, but obviously safe. So yeah, mission accomplished. Had a little treat just before we left Aberystwyth. Just on the seafront, I saw what I thought was a plastic bucket in the sea, but luckily Dad had a second look, and when we looked closer, it was actually a guillemot just floating off the beach, which is amazing. We've since come to Aberaeron, and we walked up along North Beach, and there was a bit of a wader haven with lots of curlews and oyster catchers and a few others, including golden plover. And yeah, just heading back now after quite a successful day out by the coast. It's Friday the 26th of January, and it's sunny and chilly, and we're just off to one of my favourite places, Llanelli Wetlands. One of the many brilliant things about Llanelli Wetlands is that, as well as having all the kind of wilderness around it, there is a collection of captive wildfowl which are adorable. They're very varied, there's all sorts of things from all around the world. The famous nenes from Hawaii, and lots of other geese and ducks from all over the place. And they're well looked after, and most of them are quite tame, so you can get quite close. But it's, yeah, an added bonus to come in bird watching. been in the British Steel Hide, which is quite a successful hide usually because it kind of overlooks two different areas of water. And there are a lot of people in there waiting to see a pallid harrier, which has been around, but we didn't see that. But we did see a lot of waders. There were loads of lapwing on the little kind of ridge behind one of the ponds, and a lovely green shank, which is always a treat, and lots of ducks. Winter is a great time to see ducks in the UK. And they're often in full fresh plumage as well after their kind of autumn eclipse. There were lots of widgeon, which are probably the cutest UK ducks, I think. And some shoveler and teal, and of course mallard, a couple of tufted ducks, and lots of gulls as well, including one lesser blackback, which is a new one for the list. Lesser blackbacks look very like herring gulls, but if you can see their legs, they've got yellow legs. That's the clue. Whereas herring gulls have kind of got like a kind of dirty pink leg. Yeah, we're going to continue our hunt, see what else we see. Mid-afternoon and we're starting to lose the light a little bit, but it's been an incredible day. We've seen a magnificent 46 species already today just at Llanelli. Sadly, only a handful of those are for the year list because we see most of them already this January. But some beautiful views of wildfowl, still water, bright sun. It's just been the most picturesque of days. Just what Llanelli Wetlands does best. It's been a great day and yeah, we've brought the total up a little bit. Well, we've just got back and it was fabulous, and we did make it to 49 in the end. And the 49th bird was in fact a pallid harrier, which should no way be in the UK whatsoever. They normally live in like Eastern Europe and I think they breed in Scandinavia. But yeah, they absolutely don't come here. I think this is the fifth record in Wales ever. We knew there was one around because we'd seen it in the sightings list and stuff, but you just think, yeah, you're never gonna see it. But I went back to British Steel Hide just to see if there were any more waders, and lo and behold, a very kind man showed it to me in his telescope. It was sitting on the grass out towards the estuary, and within a few minutes of me watching it, it took off and flew around in the sunset, which was glorious. So an excellent 49th bird, and I think we're up to 70 something on the year list now, so that's pretty awesome.